The NBA bubble has been one of the major stories of success in 2020. After most of the sports events and seasons were either canceled or suspended to prevent potential coronavirus outbreaks among players, things weren't looking good for pro basketball. But the league managed to put together an ambitious plan to bring the season back and eventually crown a champion, all while keeping players and team staff safe from the pandemic. Now, over a month after the season restart, things are going even better than expected for the league when it comes to the on-court product. But as the days go by in Orlando, many side stories have given way to the question, is everything actually okay inside the bubble? Welcome to Courtside. Today, we'll take a deeper look at what's been going on in Disney World for the players while we try to answer this question. We all know it by now. Myers Leonard is the king of the beer-chugging challenge. Jimmy Butler is selling coffee cups at 20 bucks a pop. The Lakers are going at it with their Madden NFL 20 tournament. And there seems to be a not-so-secret club of wine-loving players. We also know that the seeding games delivered some of the most pleasant surprises of the season. How the Bucks, Lakers, and Clippers were suddenly looking rusty at first. And how Devin Booker and Damian Lillard played some of their best basketball to date. And now as the second round of the playoffs is getting started, and so far, not a single player has tested positive for coronavirus. The NBA is looking like the best league in the world, while others, like the MLB and college football, are still scratching their heads for answers. But behind the excellence of the safety protocols that the league has implemented, the jaw-dropping performances of players like Jamal Murray, Donovan Mitchell, and Luka Doncic, and the excitement the playoff basketball generates, some stories can get overlooked because of how good things seem to be going inside the bubble. First, there's the growing concern among players regarding social injustice and, specifically, the protests against racial discrimination in the United States. It's no secret that the majority of players, as well as part of the coaches and team's executives, are African Americans. It's also well known how, to a greater or lesser extent, at least part of them have suffered from racism. Because of this, when protests erupted in late May following the death of George Floyd at the hands of a police officer, many players took to the streets and to social media to express their indignation with the situation. Among many others, LeBron James and Jaylen Brown were some of the stars that more openly expressed their desire for justice to be made regarding the case. But when rumors about an eventual restart of the season started, players were suddenly divided on what to do with the season. While some were looking forward to the chance to get back on the court, especially those who were on contenders, others thought that it would only create a distraction from the protests. Back then, Brooklyn Nets star and NBPA Vice President Kyrie Irving was among those who questioned the eventual resumption of the season. Supported by Lakers guard Avery Bradley, it was rumored that he was leading a coalition of players who would elect to opt out. However, when the time to make a decision came around, most of the players decided to head to Orlando and try to win a championship inside the bubble. And while the courts in Disney World showed a Black Lives Matter message and players and coaches were constantly talking about the topic, the focus eventually shifted from the social issues to the on-court product. But tensions would rise following the shooting of Jacob Blake. In the days that followed the event, most players were visibly annoyed and emotionally drained, and there were talks about a potential boycott of the games. And when the Bucks players refused to play in Game 5 of their series against the Orlando Magic, the basketball world took a collective gasp as no one knew what had just happened and, most importantly, what was going to happen next. The uncertainty was also among the players, as the protests had not been planned, but suddenly, all of them had refused to play, and the league had postponed its games while it looked at what to do next. There was tension among players and owners, and no one knew what to expect. During several hours, the only information that came out of the bubble was that there were various meetings taking place to decide what the next steps going forward should be. In the end, after a couple of days that seemed to put the season in jeopardy once again, the players, the league, and the Board of Governors reached an agreement to keep it going forward. But for a moment, we were reminded of how fragile the season was. And this movement came at a time when, seemingly, everyone at the bubble needed to drain their emotions. Many players had repeatedly talked about how hard life in Disney World was. Not the games themselves, but the fact that they were locked inside a place where the only things they could do was play and talk about basketball. There were no family or friends inside the bubble. There were only players, coaches, and staff, all trying to do their best to bring an exciting product to the court, but struggling to get disconnected and missing their loved ones. LeBron James had insisted on this, and most recently he talked about how he's had numerous nights and days thinking about leaving. But it wasn't until Paul George decided to open up about how his state of mind had taken a huge toll in the last weeks that we could learn how the players were feeling and how these situations were affecting their production. During the seeding games, George had performed well and his long-range shooting was at its best. However, he mentioned how he seemingly couldn't find a shot between the restricted area and the three-point line. Then after a good game one in his team's first-round series against the Dallas Mavericks, he put together one of the worst stretches in playoff history. Between games 2 and 4, George failed to score over 14 points and his shooting percentage was under 25%. The Clippers also lost a couple of games and PG was taking the blame and being accused of not being able to live up to expectations. However, following a spectacular Game 5 in which he led his team to a crushing victory over the Mavericks, he talked about how he had been dealing with depression and anxiety because of the conditions in the bubble. His mental health had been affecting his game, and after he opened up, other players followed and expressed their support. Lakers guard Danny Green described the situation by saying, "The bubble is as good as your play. If you're not playing well, walls are going to close in on you. Trust me, I know exactly what PG is going through. You have nothing but to look at your phone and social media all day, and all they're doing is bullying you." Mental health issues had turned into something the league decided to work on following declarations of stars Kevin Love and DeMar DeRozan in previous years on how they had been dealing with depression. But the bubble represented a whole new challenge, one for which no one was prepared, that could have caused teams like the Lakers to play poorly in the last few weeks. As PG talked about it and was immediately backed up by other players, it became evident that the coronavirus was not the only concern in Orlando. Now, it wasn't only a virus that the players were fighting against, but also the loneliness and the pressure, as well as the sacrifices that the season restart implied. And last but not least, there's the financial standpoint. Nobody knows exactly how much money was lost because of the pandemic, nor how much will it be recovered with the seeding games in the playoffs. The only thing that is known is that the NBA made a $170 million investment to create an environment in which the season could be safely concluded. But it's safe to say that the losses suffered will affect how the future of the league will look. As a business that depends on fans attending games, the NBA suffered a big blow because of COVID-19, and this will potentially impact how free agency and the eventual next season take place. As fans, we can only wait for the league to find a creative way to go ahead and bring basketball back somewhere in the months after the current season is finished, just like it did with the bubble. But we must be conscious that it won't be an easy task. Meanwhile, we hope that this season doesn't suffer any other setbacks. If things go right, the new champion should be crowned by October, and then we might get a clearer picture of what may lie ahead. But for now, that the players and the teams that advance to the second round can bring their families and friends to the Disney World facilities should be a relief for them and help them to make the playoffs even better. Overall, 2020 has been difficult for everyone, but for those that have been forced to try to win an NBA championship and deal with an environment that can cause depression, while also trying to make an impact on problems related with social justice, things have been a little harder, to say the least. The fact that the season is still going is an impressive feat itself, but the commitment that the players are making so that the bubble became a success is worthy of admiration. And we will keep our fingers crossed so that they can keep giving it their all. But now, what are your thoughts about the bubble? Do you believe that it should do something to improve the players' conditions? Let us know in the comments. We hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, remember to like it and subscribe to our channel for more NBA content. We are Courtside.